Hey, what's up guys, Darkbreaker here, and for today's video we are playing a solo rank gameplay and we are going to review Liebang's build, SGP Liebang, one of the best, if not the best jungler right now in AOV, and we are reviewing his pro build, going for a heavy crit build, Claves into Devil's Handshake combined with a dual enchantment. You are actually going to sustain a lot, like so much, because the more auto attacks you do, the quicker you are going to proc the dual rune. So instead of revive, burst rune or the green enchantment, he is now going for the dual rune, and let's see how it goes. And don't expect the most craziest game. Actually, the gameplay is pretty awesome. The gameplay is pretty good, considering that we only have 4 games on Sinestria right now. So not insane pro gameplay, but I would say a solid gameplay. So at the beginning, I like to play with the range form immediately so that I can proc the S2 damage onto the buff. I don't even need to use my smite, and I will do so much damage. And right now I'm just writing, you don't have support item, and if he's going to leech, see, that's what I mean. Because he didn't have the support item, he leech experience, and that's why I didn't get the level 2. And right now I'm just pinging him retreat, because when he's too close, he will leech XP, and I'm not getting my level 4. I'm not going to get my level 4 anyways because of him. See, I'm just waiting for him to leave me, and he's like, okay, shut up. Yeah, nicely done. Best Gildor, dude. I hate every Gildor support player, legit. Every time, I don't know who uploaded a video about Gildor support, but Gildor support is absolutely trash. And if you're playing it, I will report you. I probably don't report you, but in my mind, you're getting reported for playing this hero. Play him in the mid lane, it's okay, but playing him as support, trash as fuck. It's just super bad. Don't play this hero as a support. You don't really have any impact except for one play, and that's going to be your ultimate flicker. But besides that, you don't really have peel. You have like every few seconds you can shoot your stun, and if you hit it, yeah, that's nice. But if you don't hit it, yeah, then you're useless for the next 5 or 6 seconds. So in my opinion, Gildor support is horrible, and please don't play that hero. And you will just tilt your teammates, and your teammates will hate you as well. And they will report you for feeding and not having any impact. Like 1 out of 10 times maybe Gildor support will be useful, but in the other 9 times he will just be bad. So please don't do Gildor support. Anyways, right now I'm just focusing on farming up at the top lane they are fighting. Let's just clear the mid wave. So compared to the last time, I found out 2 tips that I can give you for Sinestria. You start in range form, you try to get stacks onto the opponent, right? And then you can shoot the S2 again. If it hits opponents, it will do damage on the path, and if you do it on yourself, you get healing. So what can you do? You can use range form, get stacks, then you use the S2 onto the opponent, like you are using the splash, right? And then you immediately use your S1 on top of the S2. So you will splash on top of them, do a lot of damage, and you will heal yourself, because you are also dashing forward into the blood that you're shooting out. So that's combo number 1. That's a slight tip I can give you. And the next tip is going to be, you can tower dive with Sinestria really well. So you use your S1, and instead of targeting the hero that you want to target on, you can jump onto the tower first, and then you can jump again. And you're not getting focused immediately, because you're invincible. if you don't do anything. So that's a pretty solid tip that I can give you on Sinestria. And let's see, we jump forward, we heal ourselves quickly up again, and we get another kill. Obviously calculated. I like to stay in the range form non-stop because range form does the most damage, and when you're low life you shoot the blood, the S2 onto the opponent and then dash forward, you will heal and do damage, and then you are immediately into the melee form, and then since you jumped right onto the opponent you can use the melee form to its maximum potential to lifesteal back again. Okay, let's see if we can kill this guy. Okay, nope. I guess let's clear the wave right now, since we can kill the pain. Okay, oh. You see? I use the ultimate, I'm immediately full life again, it's crazy. And now we're in the range form, just poking. Use the S2 on top of Zip, and he survives super low life, unfortunate. I switch into range form to maybe go for Omen. Use the S2. Okay, never mind. I didn't use the S2 in time. Maybe if I pressed the S2 quicker, I could have splashed on top of Omen and get the kill there. But he managed to survive. Super unfortunate. Low life, 1% HP. And right now, I'm just getting red buff. I know I could go for... Wait, let's get the top wave as well. At this point, we are so fed, I decide, yeah, okay, let's just farm up and then go for even more kills, considering the more kills, the better for the video. I mean, obviously, I could go for Slayer Rush in 1 minute, but if I go for Slayer Rush, the game is going to end within 1 minute, so I don't want to do that immediately. I'm super fed right now, and I want to get more kills. Obviously, if you just want to finish the game quickly, I always tell you guys, 7 minutes, if you are ahead, just rush Slayer, kill someone first. And if you are more people, it's an easy Slayer. Or if the opponents are on the opposite side, easy Slayer, and then you can just finish the game off. Just put it in the base, group, create a big wave on 3 lanes, and then you can just end the game. Kill this guy. And we still have our ultimate as well. S2, let's splash on. Look at our damage. S2, S1, and this guy dies as well. Just Sinestra's. Like, do you guys want me to play a lifesteal build for Sinestra? I was thinking about going Fafnir, Hercules, Omnis. You will have so much lifesteal when Hercules procs. The amount of lifesteal you're going to get is going to be insane. And this guy thinks he can fight me. I even have enhanced restore, no problem. We use our ultimate to stun him for a second and trade. I was low life, he was full HP, and we easily won the fight. That's Sinestra for you, Sinestra. Ultimate, never fight her when she still has her ultimate. She will just turn the 1v1 super hard. Never fight her 1v1. From 10% or 20%, she's just going to heal up again. And if she's melee form, she will lifesteal so much. So don't underestimate her. Try to silence or stun her when she's low life to burst her down. Otherwise, she will just sustain up quickly. And the synergy of Devil's Handshake and Duel is just mind-blowing. And I will show you something really quick. Death Seeker in combination with the ultimate is super dope as well. When you have 7 stacks, you can use your Blood Ritual to revive and you will get 100% HP back. And you will have the Death Seeker proc. So you can immediately go into range form, do a lot of damage. Just the ability to, you're super low life, you use your ultimate, you're full life again. You're super low life, you activate your passive blood ritual, you're full life again. It's absolutely hilarious how much sustain she has and how much damage she has. This guy triple kill right now, we're diving, I'm looking, where are the others, bot lane. Let's go quickly there, go into range form, kill this guy. Now use our blood ritual to revive quickly because the Tulin ultimate would have killed us. And right now I'm looking forward, let's get the mega kill. Can we get the mega kill? We kill him and we have Devsicle. Devsicle saved us from the fountain shot. Let's see if we still manage to get the mega kill. I think it might be super close. Quad kill at least, maybe even mega kill. Using Laibang's build for the first time. No, second time actually. But fourth game, Sinestra, 32% damage. Not too high, but still solid. And it's just a quad kill, that's unfortunate. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay and I see you next time. Bye bye.